Greetings. New YouTube policy changes allow them to post ads for their profit on every video they host. My account is not monetized and never has been. Feel free to skip any ads shown or use the Brave browser. Greetings. Well, I was just trying to be thorough, and now I've created more work for myself. Or at least come across something that needs clarification. It appears there may be several versions of Deedat's combat kit floating about the internet. I was attempting to find any copies on the internet that contained Deuteronomy 13, colon, verses 8 through 9. Instead of the error, Deuteronomy 13-89. And I found one. Apostasy. Neither shall thine eye pity him, the apostate. Neither shalt thou spare him, neither shalt thou conceal him. But thou shalt surely kill him. Thine hand shall be the first upon him to put him to death. And there it is, highlighted in yellow. Deuteronomy 13:8-9. Then I noticed it was numbered 5 and not 6. It's always important to explain the observables. So I wondered, why is the number different? Having two versions, I can compare the two for differences in topics, order, etc. Here is the difference that caught my attention. In the previous version, which was text, apostasy was numbered 6. In the new PDF version I downloaded, apostasy is numbered 5. Comparing them in context, one is AIDS and homosexuality, which is not in the new PDF. We have Arabs in Arabia, Abraham, absurdities, alcohol, apostasy. Next, we have Baca is Mecca, which is not in the new PDF. The simplest refutation is alliterative. Baca is Mecca is Kaka. But I'll address it in a more scholarly way in the next video. Then move on to bastard, and circumspectly, circumcision, as the Lord permits.
This just in. I got an 8.5 from the East German judge for using the word circumspectly correctly in a sentence. We now return you to your regularly scheduled programming. 10 is contradictions in the Bible in both. David is in both. Elohim is not in the new PDF, neither is the genealogy of Jesus. Then we have God, qualities ill-befitting God. God with a small g. God, contradictory attributes. And God, not a fabricator of confusion. Then we get to God, further contradictory qualities. The Holy Ghost, incest. And the new PDF does not cover Ishmael or Isaac. Israelites? Again, Jehovah is not in the new PDF. Jeremiah, Jesus peace be upon him. Jesus peace be upon him, a God? Question mark. Jesus peace be upon him, a racist. Jesus peace be upon him, sundry tit bits. That is exactly the way it's spelled. Jews, a rebellious people. Keturah, third wife of Abraham. Massacre, Melchizedek. Messiah, translated Christ. Muhammad, peace be upon him. Onanism, original sin, is not covered in the new PDF. Paul, pigs, polygamy, prophecies, prophets, butt naked. Okay, that's the way Deedat spelled it. Rape, Sabbath, Sarah, slavery, sodomy, sons of God, swine, whoring, women, worship. And then, glue the combat kit into your Bible. Is included in both versions. So there are 7 additional topics in the text version I have previously had a copy of. AIDS and homosexuality, Baca is Mecca, Elohim, genealogy of Jesus, Ishmael or Isaac, Jehovah, and original sin. Were these actual additions by Deedat in a second printing? Or just some overachiever creating a superset based on the combat kit and then adding issues of his own particular penchant? Or were they removed in an update to the combat kit because they were such obvious, indefensible frauds? It does not really matter because you will hear all these same errors and misrepresentations repeated by those spreading Muhammad's religion.
Given there are two lists, I will probably begin referencing both numbering systems. Before pressing on, though, I want to raise some ancillary topics. 2 Peter 1:16, "For we have not followed cunningly devised fables, when we made known unto you the power and coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, but were eyewitnesses of his majesty." Spreading the gospel, the good news, or in Arabic, the Injil, is not about clever arguments or cunningly devised fables. 2 Timothy 4:2, "Preach the word, be prepared in season and out of season. Reprove, rebuke, and encourage with every form of patient instruction." Preaching includes positive and negative aspects of instruction and interaction. John 13:35, "By this everyone will know that you are my disciples, if you love, agape, one another." This is a fundamental separator between Christianity and all other religions, including our root, Judaism. The revelation of God's love, agape. God's nature as agape. Ephesians 4:15, "But speaking the truth in love, agape, we should grow up in all things into him who is the head, Christ." The truth must be shared with those who do not have the truth. The truth can be naturally offensive, especially to those who have rejected it. So our struggle at times is how to be loving so we do not cause the offense. And I admit, I can completely fail this task at times. 1 Corinthians 13:1, "Though I speak with the tongues of men and of angels, but have not love, agape, I have become sounding brass or a clanging cymbal." There is no agape in Islam. There is none in the Allah of Islam. We cannot be hurt or offended that Muslims behave like their deity who has no love. But how can we possibly do that? Not be hurt, not be offended. Galatians 2:20, "I have been crucified with Christ, and I no longer live, but Christ lives in me." It's hard to offend a dead man. If you're dead, you should take no offense. "The life I live in the body, I live by faith in the Son of God, who loved me and gave himself up for me." 1 Peter 3:15, "But in your hearts, sanctify Christ as Lord. Always be prepared to give a defense to everyone who asks you the reason for the hope that is in you. But respond with gentleness and respect." If you are uncertain, your timidity can be taken as lack of confidence or confusion, uncertainty. It also leaves you vulnerable to cunningly devised fables like Deedat's combat kit, his blizzard of Blarney, his grocery lists of garbage. Now get this straight, I am not calling Deedat garbage or any names, just the claims and frauds and lies he spews are garbage. So why spend the time to refute Deedat's combat caca? First, so that you the Christian may know with confidence that it is illogical and fraudulent rubbish, so that you might be prepared to give an answer when you encounter this rubbish, this flurry of fraud parroted by Muslims. And if you are Muslim and if you desire any honest truth, you can examine Deedat's claim being scrutinized and discredited. Oh Muslim, do you have any desire to use the brain God your creator gave you? If you recoil at that question, ask yourself why. Why can't you honestly, simply say, "Yes, I do, I desire the truth"? I invite you to desire the truth, because I am confident I know the truth. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.